Welcome to the YouTube channel Physics Theories and Numericals. Here we are providing you high quality videos for easy and joyful understanding of physics theories and concepts for life. Once you understand the theories, handling of numericals will be easy. We also welcome you to the best MCQ series video for CBSE Class 10 Physics. This one is for refraction through lens. We have designed the best MCQ series videos with lot of care. Here, we are providing you high quality MCQs. We will be starting from very fundamental level and we will be moving on to more difficult level of MCQs. With each and every MCQs, we are providing you explanations so that you can refresh your concept and strengthen them. This is just not a video. This is a mock test also. With each and every MCQ, we are providing you timers so that you can put in your thoughts and come to your option before we take you to the answer. So we will suggest you to use this video as a mock test also. This will be approximately 15 minute video and we are providing you 10 good quality MCQs in this. So if you calculate, you will find a very high learning volume to the time spent ratio. So we will suggest you to go through the video till the end and enjoy the high quality MCQs. We have already uploaded 5 videos for CBSE class 10, 3 videos for spherical mirror and 2 for refraction. For spherical mirror, we have uploaded videos for concept MCQs, numerical MCQs and ray diagram MCQs. And for refraction, we have uploaded concept MCQs and numerical MCQs. We will provide you the link in the description box so that you can go through the videos in case you have not gone through already. This video is for refraction through lens. Here we will be using the standard symbol capital O for optical center, capital C for center of curvature, small r for radius of curvature, capital F for focus, small f for focal length, U, V and M for object distance, image distance and magnification respectively. Here comes the first MCQ. Which of the following characteristics are true for a concave lens? There are 8 characteristics given. They are thick in the middle, it converges, parallel ray, thin in the middle. There are 8 characteristics. You need to find out which characteristics is true for concave lens. You have got 15 seconds time. Your timer starts now. If you think you require more time in between, do pause the video, get your answer ready and come back to the video. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is option C. That means statement 3, 4 and 8, they are correct. That means for a concave lens, it is thin in the middle, it has got virtual focus, and it diverges parallel rays. Next MCQ. Which point among center of curvature and focus is closer to the optical center? Which of the two points is closer to optical center? 4 options, 10 seconds time. Your time starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is focus. Focus is closer to optical center. In fact, it is halfway to center of curvature. Distance from optical center to center of curvature is double the distance of optical center to focus. So focus is closer to optical center than center of curvature. Next MCQ. Which lens is to be used to obtain parallel rays from a point source of light? Concave, convex, plane, any of the above. 10 seconds time, timer starts now. You won't really require 10 seconds time here. Time's up, let's see the answer. The answer is convex lens. So convex lens basically converts point source of light to parallel rays. Next MCQ, which lens is to be used to converge parallel rays to a point? Concave, convex, plane, or any of the above? 10 seconds time, timer starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is again convex lens. So convex lens basically converts parallel rays to a point source. Next, when a set of rays parallel to principal axis converge into a point, what is that point called? What is the name of that point? Optical center? Center of curvature, first focal point, second focal point. What is the name? 10 seconds time. Timer starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is second focal point. In case parallel rays are coming and they are converging onto a focus, or for a concave lens, they appear to be coming out from a point, that focus is called second focus point, second focal point. Next MCQ. Identify the incorrect statement for a lens. A ray that passes through center of curvature and focus. Option A will move through the optical center. Option B is moving on the principal axis. C, coming from infinity. Option D will move undeviated. 10 seconds time, timer starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. The answer is option C. The ray need not come from infinity. There can be a point source as shown in the diagram. The ray is moving on the principal axis. It is passing through center of curvature. It is passing through focus. But it need not come from infinity. So option C is the incorrect statement. Hope you are liking the video. Please subscribe to the channel, like, share and comment on the video and press the bell icon. Let's move on. Next MCQ. You have got three circular pieces of glass. The first column gives their physical shape. You have to match the pieces with the properties given in the other two columns. The physical shapes are for the three glasses. One is thick in the middle, another is thin in the middle, third one is uniform in thickness. Their properties, parallel rays passing through it, for one it will not deviate, for another it will converge, for the other one it will diverge. And the lenses are concave, convex and not a lens. So you have to match the three columns. You need to choose from the options. It's 15 seconds time, timer starts now. Time's up. Let's see the answer. Answer is option B. Let's do some arrow marking also. The first one is thick in the middle. That means it is a convex lens, so it will converge the parallel rays. So it is 1B and Y. That means among options, A and C is gone out. So it will be either B or C. The next one, let's see. Thin in the middle, that is a concave lens, so it will diverge the rays. So the for 2 it will be 2C and X. So your option will be option B here, 1BY, 2CX and 3AZ. What is 3? That is uniform in thickness. So it will not deviate the rays, and it's not a lens, it's a plain glass. Next MCQ. Identify the correct statement. What it says, statement 1, radius of curvature of a plain glass is 0. For a convex lens, higher the thickness of the middle part, lesser is the focal length. Statement 3, for the concave lens, the middle part has lesser thickness than circumference. Statement 4, optical center is the center of curvature for a lens. Statement 5, line joining the two foci, that is F1 and F2, will have C1, C2 on it. You've got 4 options, 15 seconds time, timer starts now. If you think you require more time, do take your time, pause the video, get your answer ready, come back to the video. Time's up, let's see the answer. Answer is option D. Let's look at each statement carefully. The statement 1, radius of curvature of a plain glass is 0. No, it's not 0, it's infinity. Radius of curvature for a plain glass is infinity. So statement 1 is not correct. Statement 2, for a convex lens, higher the thickness of the middle part, lesser is the focal length. Yes, that becomes a stronger lens. If the thin part is more thicker, it's a stronger lens, so it will bend the rays better. So focal length will be lesser. So statement 2 is correct. Statement 3, for a concave lens, middle part has lesser thickness than circumference. Yes, it's true. So middle part is thin. So statement 3 is correct. Statement 4, optical center is the center of curvature for a lens. No, optical center is the center of the aperture of the lens. It is not center of curvature. So statement 4 is wrong. Statement 5, line joining the two foci, that is F1, F2, will have, yes, center of curvature and focus and optical center, they are on the straight line. So statement 5 is true. So your correct option is option D. Next MCQ. Identify the correct ray diagram from the 4 ray diagrams given. Choose from the options. You have got 15 seconds time. Your timer starts now. Time's up, let's see the answer. Option C is the correct answer. See, for option A, it is being shown that parallel ray will be, after passing through the lens, it will move through center of curvature. No, it does not move through center of curvature. It moves through focus. Same for option 4 also. It will appear that it is coming out from center of curvature. No, it will appear that it is coming from focus. So option 2 and 3 are the correct ray diagram, and your option here is option C. Next MCQ, in fact the last MCQ for this video. A convex lens can burn a paper in midday sunlight if the lens is held at a distance of 20 cm from the paper. The point of burning is called what for the lens? It's called center of lens, center of curvature, focal point, optical center. What is the name of that point with respect to the lens? You have got 10 seconds time, your time starts now. Time's up, let's see the answer. The answer is focal point. That point is called the focal point of the lens. Hope you like the video. Please subscribe to the channel, like, share and comment on the video, and press the bell icon. Thank you for watching this video. We'll come up with more such videos. Bye bye till then.